Okay, so James, when did you join PSA?
I joined PSA in 1968.
Okay, well, that's a lot earlier.
A lot earlier, long time. I think there was a time where PSA was going through a transition. So I left school looking for a job. I got 3 job offered, which I shortlisted. At that time, read a bit about PSA, that it wasn't called PSA, it was called Harbour Board, and realized that the port was so important to Singapore. So I thought, maybe that is a place I want to work. So of the 3 selected jobs, I chose PSA.
Same for me, I applied. That was in 1972. PSA offered training and also offered a career, so I was quite happy actually to take up the job offer in PSA. I stayed there for 18 years. I think we met at a place called Go Down 1-5.
Correct.
Right? Go Down 1-5.
It's the older section.
Yes, correct, yeah. In Keppel Wharves.
The funny thing, not many Singaporeans will know this. Go Down 1-5 was next to today's Vivo City.
Yes, that's right, correct.
It was called Jardin Step, and not too many people know. Go Down 1-5, the section that we were attached to, has got geographical coverage of Jardin Step as well as Pulau Belakang Mati, which is today Sentosa.
Uh-huh.
Then from Jardin Step, it was built into the World Trade Center. That's how the cable car started. So I've seen it all from a very primitive, you know, location to today. Unbelievable. We inherited what is called the Singapore Harbour Board. In Singapore Harbour Board days, the employees, they don't go on shift. We don't have the slogan, the port that never sleeps. In order to live up to this slogan, we have to go on 24 hours and we got to go on shift without paying overtime. So when we cut the overtime, the paycheck of every ordinary worker was half almost by 50%.
They must have been very unhappy.
Not only were they unhappy, but they also dare not go on strike. So what they did, they worked to rule. There was a ghost law. Ships were held back. For 3 days, it happened like that. So the PM with the delegation was visiting Japan. Cut short his visit, came back to address this port problem because he knew how critical was PSA to Singapore's economy. That was something that I really saw firsthand with my own eyes.
Well, James, by the time I joined, things had settled down a lot more. I concentrated mostly on cargo handling. Ships would come to Go Down 1-5, remember? And we'd take out the cargo from the ships, discharge the cargo. Cargo was, from conventional ships, was loose cargo. We'd palletize the cargo onto wooden platforms called pallets. So eventually, we moved towards handling containers. Singapore was one of the first few ports in Southeast Asia, the first port, in fact, to invest building a container terminal, installing equipment to handle containers.
During that time, I think our neighboring countries, you know, they never even thought of investing. But our port leaders have got the foresight, the guts to go and invest in an area that is totally new, you know, in the transportation industry. And I think this is something that is very different with Singapore. That's where I think the container port will be number one for so many years.
James, if I were to look back at my 18 years in PSA, one of my fondest memories is of the friends that I actually made in PSA. I've kept in touch with many of them. We were colleagues initially, and over time, many of us got to know each other better, and I kept in touch with them even after I've left PSA. And it's taught me that friends actually do matter, you know. How about you? What are your thoughts? What are your takeaway of your time in PSA?
My deepest memory is in one of the training courses until today in my daily living, that is industrial accident. I remember attending a class by the OMM division that talks about industrial accident and productivity. There was a poster on the board with a chicken and an egg. The statement says, accident does not happen, it is cause.
Okay.
So it's saying on a poster that the egg got cracked, it's not, it just cracked by itself.
I see.
And I think PSA has done well to ingrain that in me, that we have to be very careful in everything that we do, And that accident don't just happen, it's caused by carelessness most of the time.
That sounds like very good advice.
Yes, of course, of course.